everybody.
Hi, everyone.
I think we are here just to talk about our role in SDM. You know, I think it's like most of us, we are very enjoying doing this role.
Yeah, and I think it's the one thing that we all have in common, no matter where we started. We're all here now. We're at IFF and we're designing fragrances, which is, I don't know about you guys, but I had no idea this job existed until I entered IFF. Anybody knew like what this was before? Because I had no clue.
Yes, I heard about that when I was in school, in the ISIPCA school in France, close to Paris. And they can, of course, explain you different job that you can have just today in perfumery. So I've already heard about that. And I thought from the very beginning that was not ready for being a perfumer. And that special role of evaluator or a senior design, a fragrance manager, thing that kind of stuff, a little bit vague at the very beginning, was more in line with my own personality.
It's all very vague at the beginning, and then you enter it, and then it's like entering a whole new, brave new world, isn't it? Like, I think in an SDM, the role is so...
It's very unique.
It's very unique. It's very magnificent, actually, because if you're a curious person, this is the role to be in, I think.
The more you know it, the more you fall in love. For the fragrance world, it's kind of addictive.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Students from ISIPCA always ask me, why SDM? So one thing I would say to encourage them to be an SDM is it's a very dynamic role. You wear multiple hats. You're a project manager. You're a scent designer. You're sometimes a lead for many projects. And it's a job where you interact a lot. So you're in constant interaction with multiple teams, sometimes with the customer, always with your commercial, with SD&I. All of this apart from the scent design that you do with the perfumer.
In fact, like when we talk to perfumer, I feel that our role is kind of a translator.
The thing I like the most is the combination of you learning how to manage the project while still designing, using your creativity.
So that is really something which is, we can explore the creativity. And also there's a part of project management in it that we need to be on time to deliver the product. So I feel that this role is really like a mixture of skills.
That's a great point, San. I feel like we probably are the only role within IFF where we are in contact with every other role, right? From ST&I, so like the technical side of it, to the creative side of it, to the project management, like you said, to sales, to CI, to consumer insights, to everything. We really are the kind of glue that keeps all of these projects together because our hands are in all of the pots. And that's probably my favorite thing about it as well, that we get to interact with everyone on an everyday basis. It's never the same day twice.
It's amazing how we create partnership, especially with perfumers, I guess, because you need to build a trust relationship with them. It's a daily work that you need to keep doing, and you need to keep pushing them and pushing yourself to understand. It's a really alive environment.
Yes, I agree. And sometimes it's difficult also to explain the job I have to wake up, you know, every morning, because I'm really happy to come to the office. And when people ask me, but what you do exactly, it's sometimes very difficult to explain it in very short things. And I would say that for me, working in fine fragrance, I have the feeling that I'm a little bit like a midwife of perfumery, because I really have the feeling that I'm helping, you know, perfumers to give birth to their creation. That's really amazing, thinking that I'm able to be part of a creative team behind beautiful scents that we can smell every day behind each scent. There is a scent design manager, in fact, and that's amazing that, you know, thinking that I could be part of that team.
We forget that we are also the person at the beginning as well, you know, so our role to inspire, you know, to help them.
Exactly.
Sometimes it's about coming, you know, they come with the idea and it's about helping them realize the vision. More often it has been for me is to help them come up with the idea. And in order to inspire, you have to inspire yourself. And so in order to spy yourself, you have to go out there in the world and find new ideas, or, you know, from all walks of life.
Just talking about my personal case, I'm today here in Paris for fine fragrance, but I'm already in charge of a team of prestige in New York, and I'm supposed to move in a few months. So I'm so excited with this new experience, with this idea of discovering something different, because I'm here in fine fragrance. It will be another fine fragrance experience, but in a different part of the world. And that makes things very interesting. And I know that with Fiona, because she's not in fine fragrance, but we do exchange, etc. That's quite enriching.
We are a global community, but also we're a global community of experts. And I love that.
Being part of ISIPCA was a very global experience because I had classmates from different parts of the world. But then coming into IFF, it was an even more global experience, let's say, because I get to work with different people from different parts of the world on many projects. And it makes you feel like the world is coming closer together. You get to learn so much more from people in different countries and places, and you are together as one IFF.
So Samuka, have you graduated in the program at ISIPCA? And now you're joining IFF. How do you feel about it? How was it? What was your path to get here?
I graduated from the first class of the IFF ISIPCA program. I had a great 3 years at ISIPCA in France. So I moved from India to France in order to pursue my dream to work in fragrances. And during my time at ISIPCA, I had a great experience learning from great teachers at ISIPCA, learning about the fragrance industry. And I had the great opportunity to work as an intern at 2 IFF creative centers. For me personally, the SDM role was a great fit because you're sort of a linchpin in the whole ecosystem in a way. Anytime someone picks up a product from the shelf in a supermarket or wherever, and they smell the product and they're happy that this does everything that they wanted to do, makes me really happy that I had some part to play in that product.
Every product in the end of the day tells a huge story behind it that only SDMs, perfumers knows it.
Yeah, Marina, I think that is the part that also giving me the satisfaction, you know. When we try to create a sense for the product, when you see the product on the shelf, I feel like, oh my God, my product is on the shelf and everyone is using that. And, you know, like when you start to see like, ah, I love this product, someone like your friend of this product, oh my God, like I was the one that created together with Perfumer, you know. So that satisfaction is really like amazing for me.
They are our babies. You get to call your mom and say, Mom, yeah, go look on the shelf.
Our babies.
I know that. That's what I say. We're like midwife. We're giving birth to beautiful creation and really proud. And it reminds me of the fact, you know, when you've been working for a very long period on a fragrance, sometimes it could last months or years, and you've been doing so many modifications of the same perfume in order to fine-tune, you know? And one day in the street, you can smell someone and you say, oh, wow, no, it's public. And as you mentioned, you're so proud, saying, wow.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Sorry, guys, time to go. I have to run. It was a real pleasure discussing with you today. And so I guess that we'll catch up very soon.
And I have to go as well. I have a machine stopping and I need to go and evaluate now. Bye.
Bye-bye, guys. It was a pleasure to talk to you.
Bye, everyone.